the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Goodnight message on this Monday, the 15th of November 2021, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. We listen to this encouraging message in line with the gospel passage of today, entitled, Open Our Eyes, Lord. Today we read from Luke chapter 18, verse 35 to 43. Jesus was near Jericho. It was a way he was going to pass on his way to Jerusalem. He is about to complete his work on earth, but in order for the work to be complete, he has to heal the blindness of those who were following him, who seemed to have been discouraged, who seemed not to have seen what lied ahead and what God was going to do in their lives. He does that symbolically by healing the blind man of Jericho. Luke doesn't mention his name, but Mark tells us it is Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus. He hears of the commotion. He hears people making a lot of noise, and he tries to find out what that noise is all about. It is Jesus of Nazareth passing by, and he cries out for help. Jesus asks that he be brought to him, call him. Those who were discouraging him went and invited him, and he came. He knew exactly what he was looking for. Sight. Jesus asked him, "What do you want me to do for you?" He said, "Lord, let me recover my sight." Then he said, "Recover your sight, your faith has made you well." And immediately he recovered his sight and followed him, glorifying God. And this is what we need in our lives. We need to recover our sight, to stop seeing bad things and start seeing the good things God can do in our lives. In the second book of Kings, chapter 6, verse 8 to 23, we see Prophet Elisha praying, "Open his eyes, Lord, that he may see." He looked and saw the hills full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. Second book of Kings, chapter 6, verse 17. Elisha's servant was looking but not seeing. He saw the army of Aram surrounding their town, but he did not see the host of angels protecting God's people. He was walking in spiritual blindness. We can be the same way. We might see only disappointments in our time with this COVID-19, or discouragements, or enemies all around. We might fear the stranger, complain about the lazy, and point fingers at those who disagree. We might fear that the world is lost to the devil, and we are the ones who suffer. We might be betted with putting God aside so that we can earn our fortune and have fun, only to experience everlasting loss. Elisha's prayer is a great way to address our blindness to God's rule. We can pray, "Open our eyes, Lord, that we may see." When our eyes are opened, we see sin as sin, and we see that Jesus has already won the victory. Christ already rules in heaven. This world is all in his hands. Have no fear, for we know that God wins. When the Lord opened the servant's eyes, he looked and saw the hills full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. These heavenly hosts were surrounding and protecting them. The servants' fear melted away. If God is on our side, who can stand against us? We want to go to bed tonight with this conviction as we allow Him to open our eyes in whichever situation we find ourselves tonight. You may be just seeing the bad side of your sickness right now. As you battle with that cancer, as you battle with that diabetes, as you battle with that BP of yours, I want to let you know there are angels surrounding you. See them. As you battle, as you fight this war, you are going to win when you see that you are not fighting it alone. God is fighting with you. And so we pray as we go to bed tonight. Lord, open our eyes so that we can see you are on our side. Help us to live fearless lives in a hostile world with your protection. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.